everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Chad, and today I'm going to be reacting to Demi Lovato's full album on Dancing with the Devil, The Art of Starting Over. It was requested by you guys, and I've gotten tons and tons of views and a good amount of likes on the last Demi Lovato, not the last one, but the one before, the first one I did. And yeah, you guys really liked that one, and you asked me to do the full album, so yeah, I'm gonna do that today, and I hope you guys enjoy, so let's get into it.
I will let you guys know that I am, only doing the ones that I haven't listened to, so yeah, but I hope you guys enjoy this video, and let's get into it.
I don't know what visualizer means, but this is what I'm gonna be listening to, because it's in track, or like a playlist on her channel. So, first is intro. It's only like 27 seconds, so it must be a very short song. So yeah. Okay.
I asked if anyone could hear me as I danced with the devil. And because of that, I was blind. But now I see.
Is this a song?
Let me take you on a journey. One that sheds the skin of my past and embodies the person I am today. This is the art of starting over.
Okay, that was a little scary, I'm not gonna lie. Her voice sounded a little creepy, but it's, I feel like it's very raw, like original, like I feel like it wasn't edited a lot. I don't know. I thought that was a song, but I guess not. So this is the first actual song that we're gonna be listening to. I already like it. I like the clap in the background that she has so far, and it's like a tempo. I like the beat so far. It's very chill, and I'd vibe to it. This reminds me of another song, but I forget what it's called. I love this song so much though so far. I like how it sounds. I like the tempo. I like the little claps in the background, the beat, just everything about it so far I like. I love that. It's definitely not as chill as it was before, but I can still hear the chillness, like the calmness in the background music. But her voice is definitely getting more powerful and it's getting bigger. She definitely brought it back down. So yeah, I think there's gonna be like a big moment in the song. Yep, she's back at it again. She's definitely making her voice more powerful, and you can definitely start hearing it more. This is a very nice song. I love how calm it is. I don't know if I'd add it to, like, maybe, like, when I'm sad. Like, when I'm just, like, chill, like, in a calm mood, when I don't want to, like, listen to, like, a super big pop song that's very energetic. This is probably what I'd listen to. How did I know she was about to hit that, too? Wow, I like that a lot. Definitely is a really nice song. Okay, this is Lonely People. I'm an island, I'm alone, but I'm alive. Candy apple, I want home without a prize. They're all laughing, keep on laughing, so am I. Okay, this is a very, strange song so far. I don't know if I like it as much as the last one though. I'm an island, I'm alone, but I'm alive. Crying doesn't make you charming. Only thing I'm not is sorry. Dancing at a pity party, at a pity party. Yes, we're all lonely people. Yeah. Okay, I feel like it's definitely gotten better. I like that she
didn't keep it as it was at the beginning. It was a little creepy. I don't want to be like mean about the song, obviously, but it's not one of my favorites, but I'm starting to like it a little bit more because of the different beats that have come into the song and the different like things in the background. And I'm always finding broken hearts instead. It's very like, I feel like morbid, but I don't know if I should use that word. It's very just like darker, but it's not that dark. But like, I don't know, it's just different. It's like a different type of song that I've ever heard her do. Oh, I love how high she went. This is a really nice song so far. I'm gonna actually do a rating at the end of each song. So I think for the last song, I know it's weird to stop in the middle of the song, but for the last song, I'd say it was like a 6 out of 10. That sounds like a Billie Eilish song. I don't know, guys, what you think it sounds like. You guys might love it, but I'd say it's like a 5 out of 10 for me, or like a 5.5. So yeah. Okay, guys, so this is called The Way You Don't Look at Me. Oh my goodness, I love that. I love it so far. This might be a very top contender for me. I love the guitar and like how it already sounds meaningful to me. I've lost 10 pounds in 2 weeks because I told me I shouldn't eat. I gained a new vice way more than twice. I've slept on bathroom floors. I don't want to cry, obviously, but my tears are, I'm getting teary-eyed. It's sad to hear what she went through and what she still goes through. And I've been to hell and back, but this isn't that. Cause when you say nothing, it's much worse than things I've overcome. And this hurts harder than my time in heaven. I feel like this is about her. I would think, I assume that this is the best about her ex fiance, the one that she broke it off with. But yeah, I don't know. This is so like powerful and meaningful. It's very sensitive, I can tell to her. And I love it already so much more than the last two songs we've listened to. Natural disasters, but I'm so scared if I undress that you won't love me after. And I've been to hell and back, but this isn't that. Cause when you say nothing, it's much worse than things I've overcome. She has gone through a lot, but wow. It's harder than my time in heaven. You don't think I see the way you don't look at me. Matter of fact, cause when you say she definitely nothing, brought it down. It's very like, it's much I like worse the than things in the I've background. Wow. That was really good. Oh my goodness. That's something I would definitely listen to on a regular basis. Like, even when I'm like chill, sad. Definitely when I'm sad. I would rate that like a 9 out of 10. That's amazing. I love that song so much. Okay. Oh, let me say something. So, I was over there a little bit. I definitely fixed the camera. I'm sorry about that, guys. But yeah, let's listen to it. Was it time? I was living as a prisoner inside my own mind. And there was a time where the cat and mouse tried to make me Barbie-sized, and I obliged. Cold leather over my eyes and 100-degree heat. I don't know if I like this one so far. It kind of sounds like the Friends one, but I feel like it'll get better. I don't know. I just feel like this one's more of a weird one so far. And now I'm saying no, 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 no. Oh, yes. So, she had watermelon cakes on her birthday because of weight loss, I think. I don't know. Something with her eating disorder, I think. I don't really like this song. I feel bad saying that, but this is my least favorite so far. But I feel the emotion behind it, but I feel like it's not as emotional as I like emotional songs. Long, but baby, you're free. And now I'm saying okay, I think I like the beat a little bit more than I did at the beginning of the song. I'm definitely getting used to it, but it wouldn't be on my playlist. Ooh, I like that. Wow, that was good. I liked that a lot. No, I didn't. I just lied. No, I liked it a little bit, but it was not my favorite. But yeah, I think she did a good job on it. Okay, so next we're gonna be listening to Carefully. Okay. Oh my goodness, it kind of sounds like Lemonade Mouth. Like, na na na, top down, da 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 dun dun. I don't know. It sounds very emotional, which I'm hopefully gonna like. Approach with caution, I can get overwhelming, but in the best way. So, babe, if you think you can handle me. Oh, I like this song a lot so far. It's very meaningful. I actually think this is about her fiance. I don't feel like I should say that because it doesn't have to be about love, obviously. It can be like a family member. But I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. Cause I'm strong in a way that I know how to show you my fragile. Oh, she'll be gone in a minute if you don't think you're lucky to have her. I love that. I love how her voice came from the background, too. I love that chorus. I like that chorus a lot. Oh my goodness, she brought that up a lot. It got way more powerful, now she's bringing it down. To ease out of the song. Please handle me carefully. I could be your favorite dream. Nobody can love you like I do. Wow. Oh, I forgot to rate the last song, didn't I? I didn't do Melon Cake. I'd say that's a 4 out of 10 for me. For Carefully, I would say it's a like ooh, maybe a 7.5. It's a good number. Okay, 15 minutes. Okay, I think I haven't listened to that. Okay, guys. So this is Demi Lovato, Noah Cyrus for Easy. I'll leave through the gift shop. I'm keeping all my souvenirs, keychain in a cough drop. Postcards say I wish that you were here, and I'll tell you not to worry, to make sure that you believe in me. But the hardest part of leaving is to make it look so easy. Wow. I want to keep listening to you. I just got goosebumps. I love that. Wow. I love this so far. Oh my goodness. I love how she goes like really high at the end of Easy, but it's like very like gentle at the same time. I'll leave through the side streets. Oh, this is Noah. Right by the house where you grew up, our names in the concrete. They're lasting way longer than us. I love her voice. I don't think I've listened to, maybe I've listened to a song of hers before, but I don't really listen to her songs. I'm looking for the higher road. I'm smiling just in case you see. Make it look so easy. Wow, her voice is so soulful, and it's very like it's also sensitive. I love how they made this, like I love everything about this song so far. The hardest part of leaving is accepting all the reasons that somehow we keep repeating endlessly. To make it look so easy. I want to hear them say that. I want to hear them sing the Easy together. Oh my goodness, I love that. That's like in Met Him Last Night. That's exactly what she did. She went higher than the other, than Noah. Accepting the reasons that somehow we keep repeating endlessly. So I'll leave through the gift shop. And they're ending it off right where they started it. Keeping all my souvenirs. Wow, that's a 10 out of 10 right there. I love that. That's amazing. I don't even know what this song's about. Change your color so fast. Tried to turn my friends into friends of the past. Okay. I don't know. I feel like I'm assuming something, so maybe I should listen to the song first. Always putting you first. Could have been your future. But you didn't even care about me like that. Cause you were looking for 15 minutes. Yeah. And now you got 15 minutes. Yeah. Pack your stuff, you can come and get it. Okay. My assumptions, I think, are correct. This is definitely about her ex-fiance. I keep saying that, I know. But she said that she didn't think that was who he was until after they started into normal life. So I definitely think that's what that's about, because I feel like that would be, like, unexpected. She definitely seems, like, angry at him, but it's, like, a funny, like, you deserve this. I like this a lot. Wow. I really like that a lot, how she went up. Okay, so she's definitely about someone, and I think it was more of like a, I don't know if I would say angry, but she's more, I don't know, she's just in a different mood in this one. I like that a lot. It's very straight to the point and subtle. Okay guys, so we have four more and then I'm done. California sober. Cashing in my chips for forgiveness. Trading in my shame for perspective.
Tired of being known for my sickness. It didn't work, I'm trying something different. This kind of brings me back to like when she was on Disney, and I feel like her voice just sounds so similar to when she did when she was younger. I don't know. I feel like this is a very meaningful song to her, more meaningful probably than some of the others that I've listened to today. She said in the lyrics, she said, oh, sorry. She said she found herself, which is good. I feel like a lot of drums are about to come in. Yes. That's exactly how I imagined it. I love this song. Wow, that was good. Okay, guys, so I actually forgot to rate 15 minutes. I'm sorry, I keep forgetting about the rating part. So 15 minutes, I would rate like maybe a 7. And I would rate California Sober probably an 8. So now it's Mad World. Oh, okay, so this is, I knew there was a song named Mad World. I love this song, actually. I think it's just like a cover. All around me are familiar faces. All around me are familiar faces. Worn out places. Worn out faces. Okay, I love how she does this. I'm not going to listen to the whole thing because I have heard it before. It's not actually her original song, but I do love it. The next one is Butterfly. And then the last song is going to be Good Place, which is what she said I think is her favorite on the album. But I don't know, just like it's the end result, like she's finally in her good place. Used to dread the month of June, 'cause it reminded me of you. It always came around too soon, not anymore. Oh yeah, did she ever overdose in June? I don't know, but it was something about June. And part of me I had to find. I love this song. It's very gentle. I keep saying that about these songs, but it's very like quiet, sensitive, gentle, like not very powerful as like it's this song kind of reminds me of Stone Cold by her. 'Cause it was killing me inside. It's supposed to feel. Is it something about a butterfly? Well, yes, obviously the song is called Butterfly, but I think something significant to her that's about a butterfly, but I forget. It might have been in her documentary. If you haven't watched it, definitely think about it. It's such a good documentary. It's 4 parts. Each of them are like 20 minutes long, except for the last one, which is 30 minutes. But they're very good, and they're on her YouTube channel right now, so I could check them out. Butterfly, butterfly, hi. Forgiveness is the hardest truth. I like this song a lot. Her voice is very beautiful in this song. And I like the little echoes from her back, it's not just her single voice, but she brought in like her voice overlapping her voice, if that makes sense. There's like multiple of her. Oh yes, I knew she was gonna bring it up. Love how she built this, I like how she builds this song up. That's probably better. I just like how she builds this song up and how it's like very quiet and sensitive at first, and it's very powerful and meaningful, and like I love it so much. Butterfly, 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 butterfly. And then she brings in her voices.
I like that a lot. I would rate that a 8 out of 10. Okay, this is the last song, guys. Good Place.
I've been called an emotional disaster by myself and by so many others after. I had trials and tribulations mastered. Tune it out with a little bit of pain and plaster.
Okay, I feel like this is going to be a very emotional song for her because now she's in an actual good place.
I chose drugs over love, money over trust till I found.
And she's been so, like, she's been through so much to get here, too.
And I chose lust over love, danger over trust till I found us.
I don't want to get teary-eyed, but I'm about to because I'm very emotional. But I really like this song so far. This is the only out of two songs that have got me emotional.
Reconciled with okay and with a whole lot of work, whole lot of hurt, whole lot of grace. Now I'm in a good place.
I really love this song.
Ace and just to end up turned around took me to dark places.
It's very, she's like reflecting on all of the bad decisions she's made, and now she's got it all figured out, and everything's good now.
Lust over love, danger over trust, till I found us.
And now she's in a good place. I'm so happy for her.
I'm in a good place. Took a while to feel this way.
Oh, I like this song a lot.
A lot of
wow.
Lot of grace, yeah.
I love this so much. It's getting more powerful.
I'm in a good place. Oh. I'm in a good place. Ooh. I'm in a good place.
Aww. Okay, guys, so I really liked most of those songs. I would rate that last song probably a 10 out of 10. That was a very emotional song. That got me teary-eyed a little bit. I was emotional. But I think only the two songs that got me emotional were that one, and I forget what the other one was called. It wasn't the Noah Cyrus one. It was before that. I forget. Comment down below what you guys, which one I did it to, because I forget. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, smash like button, subscribe, push notification bell. And just thank you for watching my videos, guys. I've been getting so many views lately, and I'm just so grateful and thankful for you guys and for you guys viewing my videos. So yeah, I'll see you guys soon. I don't know when I'll be posting next. I'm thinking tomorrow. But if not, I hope you guys like this video and watch it again if you can or want to. Okay, guys, love you. Have an awesome day. And yeah, stay tuned for more. Bye, guys.